I'm Matt Harrington, I'm an EFCO field supervisor, and for today's toolbox talk, we're gonna talk about how to place and attach an EFCO quick clamp. We've got our EFCO LITE gang built up and ready to go. In the corners, we've got our 3/4 by 2-inch quick bolts, and it's a closed moment connection, and it'll hold the gang nice and strong together. We've also got our quick pins in the middle, 30 inches apart, and what those will do is hold your face sheet together, so that way they're right, nice, even, and flush, so that way you have a good clean line for your concrete finish. And then also, we've got our quick clamps staged right where they need to go, so that way you don't have to carry them up the form when you go to set the gang into place. At this point, we're ready to fly and set the gang and attach it to the previous gang. We've got our gang flown into position here. I've got it temporarily held with my spud wrench right in here. We can have our quick clamps staged 2 per 6-foot panel here. Quick release, and we have our quick clamp off and ready to go. EFCO's quick clamp has this built-in quick pin on the end of it, and what that does is that acts as an aligner as well as a connector. When you put it in the hole and activate the clamp, that makes your face sheets perfectly flush, and then when you drive the pin home, it closes it up and holds it tight to the other gang. We're ready to make our quick clamp connection. Our clamp's hanging right there, set in place. It's usually always easiest to attach these right underneath the rib. Two or three good hits with a hammer, and it's set and ready to go. This concludes today's toolbox talk on how to attach EFCO quick clamps. For any more questions, please contact an EFCO field supervisor or subscribe to our YouTube channel.